Now, on tonight's Walk Watch, what on earth is happening at the National Trust? Think of the National Trust and you imagine aristocratic mansions and sprawling country parks where you can take the family for rambles and ice creams, an essentially conservative institution committed to preserving the past for the benefit of the present. Not a place you'd be sure for right-on identity politics, but you'd be wrong. Volunteers at Ickworth and Suffolk have been requested to wear rainbow-themed clothing and makeup this Friday as part of the Trust Pride celebrations. It's not such a big deal, it's just a bit of fun, but it's the sort of thing that seems to consume more and more of the Trust's energy. Last April, volunteers were asked to take unconscious bias training. 3 years ago in Norfolk, Trust staff were told to wear rainbow badges and lanyards to commemorate the 50th anniversary of the decriminalisation of homosexuality. Some refused. But things really took off in the wake of last summer's Black Lives Matter protest. The Trust commissioned a report outlining the connections that some of its properties had to the slave trade and colonialism. Many of its small C conservative members were bewildered by this drift into wokeness. Some resigned their membership in protest. Matters came to a head last month when the Trust boss, Tim Parker, stepped down following an internal revolt from members who had called for a vote of no confidence in his leadership. Some members have formed a group called Restore Trust, explicitly aimed at correcting what they see as this unnecessary move into woke politics. The culture wars are not over at the National Trust, and if they can happen there, you can be pretty sure they can happen anywhere. Let's speak now to Andrew Doyle from GBNews' Free Speech Nation. Andrew, how did this come about? How did the Trust decide to go down this road?
Yeah, who would have thought that the National Trust would become this battleground for the culture war? Where it comes from is the same place that all of this stuff is coming from in various institutions across the country, is this ideological push, what we might call social justice or critical social justice, as some people call it, or as more colloquially people say, the woke movement. And it's often misunderstood. You see, a lot of activists and commentators are trying to frame this as the National Trust are just sort of innocently trying to teach people a bit about the slave trade and colonialism and the way in which the former owners of the properties had some kind of complicity in that, and that you've got all these fusty old conservatives who just want to whitewash the past and pretend that the empire was all wonderful and that Britain never did anything bad. That's not what's going on here at all. Everyone knows that a lot of these properties date from the high point of empire. Everybody knows that a lot of these rich people were incredibly exploitative. I mean, even the properties themselves are designed as an expression of power. That's why you get this grandeur and all these acres of property. That's the whole point. They're status symbols. So people already know that. What it is they want to be able to go for a day out to these places, relax, get some escapism, and not be sermonized about things they already know. We don't mind. Nobody minds about education about Britain's past. I think that's actually really important. You know, if the National Trust want to put displays up which give information about the people who used to own the properties, and it would be in fact very strange if they omitted information if, for instance, the owner of the property made money out of the slave trade and drove that money into the property, then of course that should be mentioned, and it would be weird if it wasn't. So what we're talking about isn't people who don't want to be educated, who aren't interested. They just don't want it to be at their day out when they're just going for a walk with the family in peaceful gardens.
The resignation of the boss, which happened last month at the National Trust, that hasn't entirely ended hostilities, has it?
No, and to be fair, Tim Parker and the National Trust have said that he didn't step down because of that pressure. But what we do know is the faction called Restore Trust had planned to have a motion of no confidence against him. So there's definitely this feud going on within the Trust. And I mean, you mentioned the idea that people should be wearing rainbow colours and flags this Friday. And like you say, it doesn't seem like that big a deal. But a lot of people don't really want to be politicised in this way. They don't want to be showing symbols at work. I mean, if we take the rainbow flag, for instance, we've had, as of yesterday, in fact, the NHS in Scotland, staff members are expected to wear to sign a pledge saying that they support the LGBT community, and they're expected to wear a badge to signify this. Now, a lot of this has come from partly from the SNP, but also with advice from Stonewall as well. And the trouble there, you see, is that people at work may not want to wear that badge for whatever reasons. Maybe they have religious convictions that don't align particularly well with that symbol. But also, the symbol of the flag used to simply mean equality, acceptance, tolerance, all the things that we all agree and believe in. The flag, as it currently stands, it keeps changing because they keep adding extra stripes and things like that. But at the moment, it has connotations of an ideological movement that is connected to this identity-obsessed intersectional movement. And it's not the same thing. It's actually quite an anti-liberal movement. So this is a very different thing. It would be the equivalent of being forced to wear a religious symbol at work. And that's not a good thing. And a lot of people don't like it, particularly a lot of gay people who are a bit sick of being treated as the useful victims in all of this. You know, we live in a society where to be openly homophobic is frowned upon virtually across the board. And the idea that a member of staff or someone at the National Trust would need to wear a badge to show that they are okay with all of this, it seems nonsensical in the current climate.